Before we get started, I need to offer a bit of a disclaimer. As many of you know, the story of G4 is one that gets a bit controversial at the end. Certain events regarding G4 a couple years ago were made viral and were highly politicized. Now, Medora Entertainment was not, is not, and never will be a political channel. I have always made my history videos with the intention of stating the facts of each brand's history and being objective about it. So I will do my best to do the same for G4, and will be careful not to uphold any one side of the issue of G4's downfall. If you have very strong opinions on this matter and want to watch a video which upholds your version of events and would be uncomfortable hearing something which does not completely uphold your version of events, then I'm afraid this video is not for you. And now, on with the show. God, I really hope my channel survives this. It's been around 4 years since I covered tech TV, and since then, everyone has been asking for a G4 video. Well, since it came in third place on the last community poll, it's now finally time to cover it. I was much more familiar with G4 growing up than tech TV, although I wasn't really old enough to watch it or get much out of it. I remember the cool channel bumpers, and that's about it. My brothers and my father, though, definitely got a lot out of it. Years later, I heard about the G4 revival and thought it was pretty cool, but didn't really watch much of it. But because the story of G4 is directly tied to the story of tech TV, it was only inevitable that I would one day cover this much beloved and somewhat controversial channel. But in any case, let's get to it. Comcast launched G4 on April 24th, 2002 as a rival to technology website ZDNet's technology channel, TechTV. In fact, when G4 was created, Comcast began dropping TechTV from its lineup to make room for G4 and give it viewership over its rival. If you want to learn more about that, check out my video on TechTV. Link is in the video description. Following massive layoffs, TechTV unfortunately entered a steep decline, and G4 ended up merging with TechTV on March 25th, 2002, creating a new channel called, wait for it, G4 TechTV. Yeah, really creative name there. About a year later, in 2005, the TechTV part was dropped altogether, although G4 Canada would retain the TechTV name until 2009. The merger alienated many TechTV viewers who felt that the shows they loved on TechTV got significantly worse under G4. However, the new G4 attracted many new fans who, before this, did not really have a TV channel focusing on video games like G4 to watch. Yes, TechTV did have some video game content, but it was more about technology in general rather than specifically video games. Some of the more beloved shows on G4, many of which came from TechTV, include X-Play, Attack of the Show, Ninja Warrior, Unbeatable Banzuke, Arena, Starcade, The Screensavers, and Code Monkeys. In late 2006, Comcast decided to consolidate many of its properties on the west coast of the US, including E!, Style Network, and G4, into a single group headed by former EU president Edward Harbert. Many G4 fans have considered this to be the beginning of the original G4's downfall, as Harbert was known for stating, quote, "Gaming has been demonstrated as being too narrow," end quote. This meant that he had plans to make G4's focus more broad and to throw the appeal of the channel to its core fans, its specific focus on gaming content rather than general technology like TechTV, out of the window. Over the following years, this new vision would start to come to fruition, as new shows started to focus less on video games and more on general action stuff, and in 2009, popular shows like X-Play and Attack of the Show were severely cut down. Around this time, viewership and overall ratings for G4 began to seriously decline, to the point where DirecTV pulled G4 from its offerings in 2010. The following year, the UFC and the WWE both tried to make deals to acquire G4, which no doubt would have led to a doubling down on the shift away from video game content, but neither deal went through. In early 2012, Neil Tiles, longtime CEO of G4, stepped down, and Adam Sessler and Kevin Pereira, who hosted X-Play and Attack of the Show respectively, also left G4, leaving G4 without many of the people who had made it successful in its heyday. Later that year, X-Play and Attack of the Show were both cancelled, leaving G4 without any new original content. I think it's safe to say that at this point, G4 was a husk of its former self, and ratings and viewership only continued to drop. Then, at the end of the year, NBCUniversal, which had been owned by Comcast since 2011, announced a deal with Hearst Corporation, owner of men's magazine Esquire, to relaunch G4 into the Esquire network, which would focus on similar things to the magazine. The relaunch was originally supposed to happen on April 22, 2013, but then the date kept pushing further and further back, and ultimately they gave up on the idea altogether and instead decided to replace Style Network with the Esquire network, leaving G4 alone. But through all of this, G4 continued to stagnate. Over the following year, G4 would continue to be dropped by TV providers, including Time Warner Cable, Bright House Networks, Verizon FiOS, Cablevision, Cox, and even Charter Communications, who had been one of the original providers carrying Tech TV in the early 2000s. Finally, on November 30th, 2014, G4 was discontinued altogether. However, little did anyone know that they had not seen the last of G4. The seeds for the revival of G4 were planted in July 2020, when G4's Twitter page was brought back to life and then a teaser for a revived G4 was released on it. Then, in September, the G4 YouTube channel began recruiting new hosts to join the pre-established G4 hosts in the new G4. In November, the X-Play YouTube channel hosted a very special G4 reunion special, where many of the people who were behind the original G4 reunited for a special Thanksgiving dinner, where they reminisced about their work in G4. It was also revealed in the special that WWE wrestler Austin Watson, also known as Xavier Woods, would be the first new host in the new G4. On January 29th, 2021, the X-Play YouTube channel began hosting B4G4, which was a series of fun live streams as something to tide the fans over leading up to G4's relaunch. Many of these streams were new episodes of X-Play and Attack of the Show, each hosted by Adam Sessler and Kevin Pereira themselves. In February 2021, esports commentators Indiana Black, also known as Froskiren, and Olivia May were introduced as new hosts to join Xavier Woods. Then, 2 months later, Alex Mendez, also known as Golden Boy, another esports commentator, was announced as another new host. YouTuber Cassin G would join him later that month. The revived G4 was originally slated to launch in the summer of 2021, but due to a host of issues, it ended up instead launching on November 16th, 2021. Another thing that happened to G4 upon launch was the addition of gaming YouTuber Scott the Woz to the channel's lineup. New episodes of Scott the Woz would air on G4 and were a big draw to new audiences. And now comes the part we're all dreading. We need to talk about Froskiren's rant. As I said in the beginning, if you have a strong opinion on this matter, then you may want to click away from this video now, because I am going to try my best to be objective with this and not promote any one side of the issue above the others. Here's how I shall retell what happened. In late January 2022, Froskiren took a few minutes out of a segment on X-Play about Red Dead Redemption 2 Online to deliver a rant. Now, for the purposes of not stoking drama or division, I will not tell you exactly what the rant was about, Many of you already know, and if you don't, you can look into that yourselves. All I will say is that many fans felt personally attacked by the rant, and then the matter became highly politicized, with many calling for X-Play's and G4's cancellation. Many cite it as the reason behind G4's demise, while others say that G4 was already on its way out even before the rant. In any case, it certainly did not help, as it gave G4 a lot of bad publicity. Many fans abandoned G4 after the rant, which hurt their viewership numbers, which were not very high as it was. But whether it was entirely caused by the rant or not, G4's viewership and ratings declined throughout 2022, and by the fourth quarter of the year, it had reached a breaking point. So, in October 2022, it was announced that G4 would be discontinued again, not even 1 year after it launched. And now for something a bit more lighthearted after that whole mess at the end. Patrick, otherwise known as Appleboy, is back to share his experiences with G4. Take it away, Appleboy.
Hello once again, Medora viewers. Always a pleasure to be here. Now, seeing as Eric's covering G4 TV today, I thought I'd stop by and give you my own personal experience with G4 TV. I shall set the scene. It's 2011. I'm over at my grandfather's house, out west, for the weekend. I'm scrolling around through the Comcast on-demand services, looking for something to watch. It may have been Little Einsteins, but I'm not quite sure. I get lost in the menus, and end up at G4's section. Being about 6 at the time, I wasn't on the internet much, and I wasn't familiar with G4. But when I selected G4's section, I saw something that stood out to me like a sore thumb for someone who had no idea what G4 was. Plain and simple, the words, Super Mario. I couldn't believe it. I quite liked Super Mario, even at this early age. I'd occasionally go online to play the Super Mario Flash duology, brilliant set of Flash games, please give them a look if you haven't already. And I was an avid watcher of the Super Mario Bros. Super Show. So, unsure of what Mario content I'd see, I selected the Super Mario video. What played was the E3 trailer for the game Super Mario 3D Land, at the time just known as Super Mario. I was in shock. A new Mario game I'd never seen or heard of before, and what looked to me like a golf club in the logo? Maybe it was a new Mario Golf game, I'd thought to myself at the time. But looking back, it was kinda silly that I thought the trailer of Mario 3D Land was for a golf game. Anyhow, until 2021, when Scott the Woz joined G4, that would be my only experience with G4 TV, and the G4 brand in general. Back to you, Eric. I'll be taking my leave now. See you around, viewers. Maybe I'll bring back some Kinect sets for you when I visit next.
Thank you so much, Patrick. It's always a pleasure to have you on this channel. Even though I never watched G4 that much, I am dismayed that it failed, even after being given a second chance. Froskieren's rant and G4's downfall are another reminder of how divisive and hostile the internet can be in this day and age. Whether the Froskieren rant was the ultimate cause of G4's demise or not, there will still be people who believe wholeheartedly one way or the other, and are willing to personally attack others for not agreeing with them. In fact, even though I tried my best to not be divisive in this video, there are probably still going to be people who have a serious problem with what I said in this video, perhaps even taking my insistence on remaining neutral as an attack on their position. However, if it wasn't obvious already, it is not my intention to attack anyone through this video. You can hold whatever position on the Froskieren rant you want. That is human nature. But even though the facts I state in these videos are not always entirely accurate, much like all other YouTubers, I am not perfect and sometimes make mistakes, I always strive to be as objective and factual as possible. If that counts as being divisive, then I don't know what doesn't count. In any case, please, don't start drama over this. for if my channel ends up imploding after this video's release, then Medora Entertainment will become yet another victim of our current internet climate, and it will be clear that the internet has learned nothing throughout the years. And as always, stay tuned.
Mais ninguém.